Hi everyone, and welcome to another episode by Poor Man Gamer. First off, I just want to thank everybody. I actually surpassed 200 subscribers, which is an incredible number because I only started this about a month ago. I really didn't think it would get as much traction as it did. We ended up building a clan. I mean, people are active on it. They're chatting and helping each other, and it's just been a great community. So big shout out to all of you guys for subscribing and liking all my videos. I really want to thank you. I'm gonna bust a myth and show you guys that I'm not as good a player as people think, and I have really, really embarrassing losses. So what I'm actually gonna do right now is show you guys some of these embarrassing losses and to show you guys that just because I make videos on YouTube doesn't mean I'm always winning, right? I have really, really embarrassing losses, and the reason I post these videos is because I myself have been so embarrassing so many times that I got sick and tired of it. So in this first example here, I got bike rushed hard, right? All I could do is keep mining, and then so I go ahead and build my pitbull. I'm trying my best to block off his attacks against his harvester. What I should have done was leave my harvester there, let it take a little bit more damage before I moved it. Okay, my first mistake. So now I have no economy going, I roll out a second pit bull, and I'm gonna lose my harvester, right? Nothing I could have really done about it at this stage of the game. And the reason I'm sharing you guys these embarrassing losses is to show you guys there is still so much more I can learn. And that is the reason why I post these videos. It's not just for all of you guys to consume, but also for myself to learn. Here, instead of building a predator tank, which is something I should have done, I actually open with a barracks because I knew he's got a vehicle thing and he's just gonna keep rushing me a vehicle. What I should have looked at right in the beginning, and stupid me, was he's using a Seth drill pod. A jump jet troop would not help me, right? So if you could take a look at here, I move my jump jets to the top and I build my harvester to the bottom. I'm actually trying to steal this missile from him at the very last second. Unfortunately, it didn't quite pan out the way I was hoping to. I didn't have quite enough firepower to steal this missile from him. He's on all three tiles. I couldn't get there in time, and I lose that first missile. I should have moved my Rhino to the top. I didn't, right? When you have such a bad start, sometimes it really just sets you back. And so I'm trying my best to make a comeback here, and I'll show you guys some of the things I did. I roll out a tank. I'm moving my Rhinos back to protect it. I engage him with my Predator tank. I'm using my jump jet troops now to protect more of my harvester. But again, because he's been able to put such good, tremendous pressure on me, I really got myself in trouble. He saw that Predator tank roll out, and because he had that economic advantage, he was able to roll out Banshees. By the time I rolled the Hammerant, look, I'll show you guys, it's just too little too late, right? I'm trying my best to get a move on here, but there's really not much I can really do at this stage of the game. I don't believe I got this missile. Nope. Yeah, his Seth drill pod killed me, and that's the end of that. Not much to watch. Very, very embarrassing losses. I'm actually going to lose against a Scarab, which is hilarious because I just posted a video on how to counter Scarabs. So I'm going to show you guys my embarrassing losses. I'm not afraid to show you guys these videos because, look, we all live and learn. Sometimes you just got to take it. These videos with a grain of salt. It's the opinion of just one guy doing the best he can to play. I'm gonna lose a lot, right? I watch the top end players play. I try to implement it. I lose a lot, right? That's not true. I win a lot more games than I lose for the most part. I usually win about 60 to 70% of my games. But look, here I got rushed so many times in the last couple decks that I decided to build a pitbull. What I should have done at this time was open with a harvester, but my mistake was trying to engage his Scarab, thinking, oh, maybe I can take this tile. Too little too late. And as you can see here, I have no economy. I should not have engaged his Scarab. I should have just been patient. I wasn't patient. And I'm going to show you guys the whole map here, and I'll show you my mistake. Again, not patient, not patient. I keep preaching patience in every video, and I'm a hypocrite. I didn't practice what I preach. I was not patient, so by the time I try to stall up the missile, I notice he's got a double harvester already, right? And look, when you have this kind of map positioning, there's no comeback, right? So I literally just eat the loss. I try to steal this missile where I can, and I believe I actually did steal that first missile, but out comes his avatar, and I just take this loss, right? super, super, super embarrassing. And that's okay. What can you do? We're gonna watch the joy of my base game blown up. Oh, that was painful. I take bad losses too, right? That's okay. So congratulations, Carlos. You beat a YouTuber, which not much of an accomplishment. I'm gonna show you guys a third video here of a guy who did a lot of microing and did a great job. I'm gonna slow down this video. I'm gonna break down for you guys all of the mistakes I made so that I hope you guys don't make the same. And I point out these videos, but I actually do end up winning quite a few more games afterwards. So I'm gonna show you guys from my perspective. This time instead of opening with a harvester, because it's such a small map, I decide, hey, let's give the pitbull a try. So I'm able to do some damage against his harvester in the beginning. Right. But he smartly uses his rifleman to block off access for my pitbull to his harvester. And he does a really good job, right? He really does. He does a great job microing. So now I open one set of shockwave troops. Knowing he's got three infantry on the map, he quickly counters with a Venom, which is very smart of him, right? Here, I try to engage his Venom. So after engaging his Venom, let's pause here. I should have backed off my shockwave troop and retreated, but instead, I just stood there like an idiot and just took on even more damage. Instead of using my pitbull to chase, I did nothing and I just stood there and I just ate his missiles. Super, super embarrassing. And now I'm rolling down my shockwave to do what? I moved my harvester by accident and I lose 20 Tiberium at least, right? Embarrassing loss, like I tell you guys. Sometimes when you're trying to micro a lot, I make a lot of mistakes playing. I find this is especially true on the PC. And so out comes this Banshee, great counter. I using a Hammerhead right now, I don't have an economic advantage. So as you can see here, I'm just getting shredded, right? I have to go 2-on-1 on him to finally get some traction. I'm just trying my best here to steal this missile, and I'm really just trying to snipe his harvester at this stage of the game. I should have kept more pressure on his tick tank, and I didn't. Right? I should have fired a few more shots on him before he settled down. Because once those tick tanks get into place, they're very, very hard to dislodge. So, again, mistake here. Instead of keeping my jump jet squad on, I should have moved it as early as I could over. I should have moved my Rhino to the top to engage him. I didn't. I lose his first missile. Very embarrassing, even though I get his harvester. More mistakes here. I should have moved my Rhino back. I didn't once I lost that missile. Here, my shockwave, I should have sent it down right away. Still standing there, not accomplishing anything. And as you can see, I just take a bad loss, right? I finally got a chance to roll my Hammerhead. I'm going on the missile. Then I'm thinking to myself, what am I doing? The missile's not even close to being done. Why am I going down there? So now I have a Hammerhead on the field that's not accomplishing anything. My Pitbull's not accomplishing anything. And look, just bad losses all the way around. Right? Now I'm finally smartening up. Look how long it takes me for me to roll down my Hammerhead. The moment I roll down the Shockwave, I should have been smart. And I should have moved it. My Hammerhead, I should have moved to the front. I didn't. Instead of engaging the Venom, I'm rolling around, taking the long way. Very, very embarrassing loss, like I said. He's able to roll out his Obelisk of Light. He's got great tile control. I try to engage him where I can. I'm trying to get the jump on that second tile. I did leave his tick tank alive on purpose, thinking I could snipe him at the last second. But again, I don't do enough here. And my jump jet troops are not the ideal unit to hold. I should have went to the top with my shockwave, but instead I rolled it down to the bottom. Another big mistake, right? And I'm pretty certain that I lose this missile. So there it is, right? I take the loss. Three really embarrassing losses, right? Totally winnable games if I practice what I preach. So the reason I post this video is just to let you guys know, hey, I'm just a regular guy trying my best to win games. I'm gonna have bad games. I'm also gonna have great games, and I'm hopefully gonna show you that in the next video. So guys, thank you for watching, and for those of you who subscribe to me, I really apologize for these really bad losses. Practice what you preach. We're all trying to get better, right? So thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day. Take care.